changed the name of Shushu, called Restart Spain, The Sun Never Sets. I couldn't find the previous name and keywords. Looking at the results, I really scratched my head. December 29, 1874, Royal Military Academy Sandhurst, England. As one of the four major military academies in the world, Sandhurst Royal Military Academy continuously provides a large number of low-level officers for the British Army every year, and many of them are gilded by the children of senior executives. The more famous British Prime Ministers Churchill, Montgomery, etc. in history all came from this university, and in the 19th century, this school was even more crouching tiger, hidden dragon. And Alfonso in military uniform was saying goodbye to his classmates. Just yesterday, the Spanish royalist General Arsenio Martinez de Campos staged a coup and declared Alfonso XII the King of Spain. From a deceased prince to one of the few supreme rulers in Europe, the sky-high contrast seems to have no effect on the 17-year-old boy this year. The wheel of history is really unstoppable. I didn't expect that the day of becoming a king would not be bad every day. The young Alfonso smiled heartily. Since his last life choked with water and passed through Spain for more than 150 years, he has become the newly born Alfonso XII. Alfonso, who is familiar with this history, knows that as long as he doesn't change anything, he will become the supreme ruler of this empire at a weak age. Spain in the 1870s could really be described as having internal and external troubles. The domestic Carlist rebellion had swept through half of the country. The country is still unstable, not to mention the development of the country. The backward economy has made the people in the country impoverished, anarchism and socialism are prevalent, and the investment in education has made most of the Spaniards illiterate. Industrialization and social inequality also led to frequent labor movements in Madrid, Barcelona, and other places, and the rural areas represented by Andalusia were also annexed by the land of the great aristocracy, and many seasonal workers who had no land even tried to use violence. Revolution. In addition to the mainland, Spain's two richest colonies, Cuba, fought a war of independence in 1868, while the Philippines also launched an uprising in 1873. The insurgents demanded that Spain implement a federal system and give the Philippines and Spain equal status. Since I am here, then I am Alfonso XII, the Spanish king of the Bourbon family. From this moment on, I will let history remember my name. Alfonso's eyes are firm, maybe no Chinese man will reject the four words of Qing Shi's name. Howard, pack up, we're going back to Spain, remember to bring my black suitcase. Yes, Your Majesty. The boss of his family has become the lord of a country, and Howard, who is Alfonso's butler, naturally knows it. Wearing a black suit, her meticulously combed back is mixed with all matches, and her face with no emotions and sorrows seems to be frozen. As the housekeeper appointed by Queen Elizabeth II for Alfonso, Alfonso began to take care of some trivial matters in the family since he was young. Although Howard did not have a proud education and command, he could keep the house in good order. The black box is a record of some of Alfonso's previous technologies. People are animals after all, and there will always be times when they forget. Good memories are not as good as bad writing, but most of them are just concepts and ideas, and they have to rely on a lot of financial resources to implement them. And manpower. Everything was well prepared, and there was no attachment, and took Alfonso's golden finger in a carriage from Surrey, England to London. Surrey is about 30 miles from London. Converted to kilometers, it is about 50 kilometers. It only takes a day to ride a horse-drawn carriage. And Alfonso's first trip was to meet with British Prime Minister Gladstone at a mansion on the outskirts of the British Empire. Hello, Your Majesty Alfonso, you are welcome. Gladstone was a fat old man, and his smooth Mediterranean and serious expression made him not seem to be very easy to get along with. Hello, Prime Minister Gladstone. Alfonso smiled. In fact, he had a good feeling for this fat old man, although the relationship between Spain and the United Kingdom as an old colonial empire was not good. However, the person in front of him, who was strongly opposed in the tragic British invasion of China in 1840, no matter what the purpose was, made him a Chinese person in his previous life. Congratulations to His Majesty's return to power. In order to show our support for His Majesty, our country will send a warship to His Majesty back to our country. Grayston said with a smile, and at this time, he was already pouring himself into the topic. Thank you for your support for me. I believe that our cooperation will continue to deepen after I return to China, said Alfonso. In the past, Gladstone was called the People's William by the people to express their respect for this man who dared to speak out against the tyranny of foreign governments. But now the prestige of the Liberal Party he leads has dropped to the lowest level among the British people. In fact, in this year's general election, Gladstone and the Liberal Party he represents were defeated by their enemy, Disraeli, who pursues imperialism. Thank you for your kind words. Gladstone didn't say much. Although it didn't seem to mean anything on the surface, it already revealed that he didn't want to talk more. The next day early in the morning, Alfonso boarded the British warship Royal Oak under the leadership of a British officer and a translator. Although she was over 10 years old when she was launched in 1862, UU read www.uuganju.com but is still the main force of the Royal Navy. And today it is it that leads Alfonso back to Spain. Speaking of the Navy, the Spanish Navy gradually declined due to Napoleon's destruction of the Spanish port in the early 19th century, but the foundation of the naval power for hundreds of years is still there, and it still maintains the ability to build. But the lack of engineers is still the fundamental reason why the Spanish shipbuilding industry is struggling. Howard, do you think I can govern this country well? Alfonso put his hands on the plywood. Staring at the calm sea with no gods, even if there are prophets and golden fingers of the future world, Alfonso, who has never experienced a high position, still has a trace of unspeakable pressure. Howard turned his head slightly to look at Alfonso and said, "Your Majesty can definitely do it. Spain is in dire straits. They need you to lead them out of the predicament." Nodding his head, he suddenly understood the meaning of his trip to the peninsula. From the moment he stepped on it, he was the ruler of this ancient country. Thousands of people's hopes were pinned on him. Drip, drip, the whistle of the battleship sounded, announcing the arrival of Alfonso. On the shore, Arsenio led a guard of several hundred people to meet the new king of Spain, Alfonso XII. "Your Majesty the King!" The guard soldiers on the shore shouted in unison. "Congratulations to His Majesty the King!" Arsenio knelt down on one knee, his head lowered. Alfonso stretched out his hand to help the sturdy general. "No need to be polite, Arsenio, you are my hero. It's Your Majesty. Please, Your Majesty, go back to the palace." Arsenio stood up and made a military rationale. As a hero and a royalist who helped Alfonso ascend to the throne in a coup d'etat, his loyalty does not need to be said. "Here is Madrid, the capital of Spain, the westernmost country in Europe, and the largest city in the country, known as the Gate of Europe as a country along the Mediterranean Sea. Even in the coldest winter, the daytime temperature remains between 9 degrees Celsius and 16 degrees Celsius, which does not make people feel cold. The Royal Palace of Madrid on the left bank of the Manzales River is the third largest palace in Europe after Versailles and Schönbrunn in Vienna. At this time, this splendid building welcomed her new owner. Canovas, in the future, I need more trouble for your assistance," Alfonso said. Canovas said, "Yes, Your Majesty, I will do my best." Canovas, full name, Antonio Canovas del Castillo, was a veteran of the reign of Alfonso XII's mother, Isabel II, who served as Minister of the Interior in 1864 and overseas territories from 1865 to 1866. Minister, Isabel was overthrown by the military in 1868 and became popular overseas and established the Spanish Republic. The old minister retired from the government and became the leader of the party supporting the Bourbon family. "I have been abroad for many years, and it is always worrying to see the situation in Spain. In order to solve these situations, I have a lot of ideas. I hope you can give me your opinions when we solve the urgent Carlos rebellion," Alfonso said. "Yes, Your Majesty, the old minister must do his best to relieve the worries of His Majesty and the country." Canova's was expressionless, but there was still a hint of worry in his tone. After all, most of the whimsical kings in history have no wise kings, right? Let's do the enthronement declaration first. This is a major event now, and it must not be neglected. Yes, Your Majesty, the old minister has retired. Canovas bowed his head and prepared to leave. Don't go yet, call Arsenio for me. I want to hear your thoughts on resolving the Carlist rebellion, Alfonso said suddenly. After a while, Arsenio, the main character of the army, has arrived. Can you two have a solution to the Carlos rebellion in the north? Alfonso asked. Your Majesty, I think that although the current rebels are powerful, they are not regular soldiers after all, and their combat effectiveness is limited. Arsenio is indeed qualified to say this, in the just concluded February 1874, when he defeated the rebels in Bilbao and lifted the siege. The main rebel forces in the north should give a strong blow. North of the Ebro, the entire northern area up to the French border and Alcoy, Seville, Cadiz, Valencia, are now under rebel control now. The rebellion must be disbanded as soon as possible and the country can be reunited before it can develop stably. Canovas pondered, the rebels are indeed the biggest cancer preventing the country's development now. Your Majesty, we can mobilize the main force of the army and launch a general attack on the main force of the rebels in the north. After the main force in the north is eliminated, the cities in the south will not be enough, Arsenio said. Alfonso nodded in approval and asked, Now, I need you to introduce me to the military situation of the country's army. Except for the colonial army, there are now 110,000 active soldiers in the kingdom, all of whom can participate in the battle against the rebels, just waiting for His Majesty's order. Alfonso sighed secretly in his heart. At the same time in Europe, the Russian army had standing 800,000 people, France 500,000, Germany 450,000, Austria-Hungary 300,000, and even the British army, famous for its navy, had a standing staff of 250,000. Up and down. Compared with Spain's 110,000 people, the Italians' 150,000 people are more than enough. If Italy adds two Sicilies, the total number is 240,000, which is basically the same as the British army and twice the number of Spain. This situation is caused by Spain's backward economy, which has resulted in the slowest population growth rate in Europe. Spain now has a population of about 16.5 million. Ranking 8th in Europe, followed by Russia with 71 million, Germany with 41.7 million, France with 38.46 million, the United Kingdom with 33.17 million, Italy with 28.63 million, and Poland, Russian, with 18.63 million. In 1800, 75 years ago, the population of Spain had reached 11 million, and the population of the United Kingdom, which was similar to Spain, was 10.5 million. In the past 75 years, the population of the United Kingdom has nearly tripled, while the population of Spain has only increased by 5.5 million. On the one hand, ongoing civil wars and instability have resulted in stagnant economic development and inevitable slow population growth. On the other hand, it is also because after the end of the South American War, it has become an immigration target for many people who want to avoid the war and have a dream of making a fortune. Arsenio, order the army to start a large-scale offensive, and at the same time order Fernand to lead 30,000 people to restore the city occupied by the rebels in the south. Antonio's grandfather, Canovas, issued an edict that all surrendered Carlos can be pardoned, and the northern provinces participating in the rebellion can retain their original privileges if they surrender. Whether Castilian, Catalan, Canadian Galicians, Basques, and now all Spaniards, do not allow the army to burn, kill, and loot. Alfonso gave Canovas an order without hesitation. The Second Carlos War in history, although aggressive, was ultimately anticlimactic. It was subsided in 1876, a year after Alfonso XII ascended the throne. And the current Alfonso is just taking the solutions from history and using it, both political and military, but he does not intend to go to the northern front to supervise the battle in person as in history. As a monarch, you don't have to do everything. Come by yourself, knowing how to employ talents is the greatest ability of a monarch. The coronation ceremony of this king is scheduled for January 15, and Canovas has worked hard to prepare the declaration of succession. Alfonso didn't forget this, after all, it represented that he became the real monarch of Spain in name. Yes, Your Majesty, Arsenio and Canovas responded in unison and slowly exited the great chamber. On the way back, the two of them couldn't help chatting about King Alfonso XII. Looking at our king, he is very determined to revive Spain, Arsenio said. Canovas agreed and said, it's not just determination, but also ability. It seems that we have to help Your Majesty well, so that he can show off his skills in Spain. After speaking, the two of them looked at each other without saying a word, their eyes were firm, then parted ways and returned to the mansion. In such a chaotic era, wealth has no meaning to them, and their status has reached the point of being under one person. Who doesn't want to leave a strong legacy in the history books of their motherland? January 5, 1875, the day after the conversation with the two ministers. When newspapers all over the country published this order, which was personally issued by Alfonso XII, who had been in power since the first day, the whole country finally began to discuss. All the Carlists, I have ordered the government's regular army to carry out a full-scale attack, all the rebels will eventually be restored, and as the new monarch of Spain, I am willing to give a chance to those who can reform, whether you are Castilla, Catalan, Garcian or Basque, we are all brothers from Spain. Therefore, I, Alfonso XIII, hereby promise, all my compatriots who are willing to lay down their weapons and are unwilling to continue killing each other, I can forgive your faults and let go of the past. And those who do not repent at all, when they end their rebellions, I will punish them with treason. Since entering the new century, this land has encountered countless wars, big and small. We should maintain our hard-won peace on the basis of national unity. When the order of the new King Alfonso XIII appeared in major newspapers, it immediately caused a huge response from the people. Hey brother, have you heard that the new King of Madrid has decided to attack the Carlos in an all-round way? In the city of Gijón on the north coast of Spain, a worker who just got off work was gossiping with his co-workers. All-out offensive is good. This war has been fought for 2 years. We don't know when we are going to fight for those capitalists and politicians. The worker said casually, but also showed his disgust for war, yes, but how can people who have experienced war like war? Since entering the 19th century, the Iberian Peninsula has experienced countless local wars since the war against Napoleon's rule, which has also made the people of this country very war-weary. When Alfonso announced a full-scale attack on the Carlos faction and revealed his yearning for peace, at least the two ordinary workers did not object. And this kind of thing abounds in this peninsula country. In fact, in the original history, Alfonso XII also gained the support of the people by quelling the rebellion of the Carlist faction, thus securing his throne. Alfonso's predecessor, Duke Amadeo from Samui, left in Spain the Spaniards can't govern because he could not get the support of the people, and then fled in embarrassment. In the Carlos site in northern Spain, although the news of Madrid cannot be spread here, there are still all kinds of gossip in secret. Although this may not shake their determination, people will always leave a way out for themselves. There are also tough patriotic youths in the Carlos army, who may rebel against injustice in the face of injustices imposed by hostile countries. But what they are facing now is only brothers from a country, and they are all Spaniards after all. Fighting between brothers is not destined to become an enemy with a feud. January 6th at this time, the Spanish army, which received the order, has been attacking northward along the Ebro River one after another. The Spanish army was divided into three groups, all the way from the east of the Ebro River to attack Barcelona. All the way to Zaragoza, a city in north-central Spain, and the last way to go straight to the Navarra area, the home of the Carlos faction. The rebellion has been going on for 2 years. The army has already assembled and faced off by the river. Now it is just an order. The Spanish army, which is not very effective, assembles unexpectedly very quickly. The Carlist authorities also knew that the regular army, which could not resist the full-strength attack, was preparing to hold on to several important cities. In history, although the Carlist War was on a grand scale, in order to stabilize the whole of Spain and restore the economy as soon as possible, a unified Spain must be indispensable. It's about to be discussed here. I believe that few people are willing to watch this civil war, so I don't bother to write about the Carlist War. It will end as soon as possible and get on the right track. January 9th, after 4 days of marching, the cannons of the three major wars have already sounded. Outside the city of Pamplona, Arsenio has already begun to order the artillery units to start shelling, and 46-pounder cannons are firing parabolically at the enemy camp. In Barcelona, Catalonia, the armies of both sides have also lined up to prepare for a fierce battle. The artillery volley fires for half an hour. After the artillery fire is finished, the infantry is immediately organized to attack, and the cavalry is ready to attack the opponent at any time. The commander of the Barcelona front was Jorgos Cazacas from Madrid. A young and middle-aged officer in his 40s, who has been losing ground since 1873, has really suffocated him. The closest Zaragoza had already started a fierce battle, and it was not long before the defeat of the Carlos faction. Your Majesty, your coronation ceremony will take place on January 15. Canovas said, "Well, let me tell you, the coronation ceremony will be kept simple, and no banquets and parades will be held." At this time, Alfonso's focus was still on the Carlist War in the north and Fernand's occupation of the cities in the south. By the way, I will inform the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and let them express their apologies to the United Kingdom, France, Germany, Russia, Austria, Portugal, and other countries. It is not necessary for countries to send people to congratulate, and they say that Spain is in a civil war, and the king is uniting with the army to deal with the rebels. I have no intention of having a dinner party for the time being. Your Majesty is wise. Canovas lowered his head and said, "I will notify the major media to report this. You see, I must show my thoughts to the soldiers on the front line, and let them know my yearning for the peaceful reunification of the motherland." Alfonso nodded. It was nothing more than a good way to increase his prestige, and he was dedicated to the country. The image of a good king is also what Alfonso wants to convey to the outside world. In addition, I went to France and the United States to invite two people to Spain. One was Maxim from the Boston Mechanical Company in the United States, and the other was a French chemist, P. Vialli. I admire their talents. If they want to come to Spain for the service of the royal family, I will pay twice their original salary. Okay, let's go. Remember that these two are very important. After Alfonso XII explained the matter, Canovas responded and went out. This is Alfonso's early cut to military talents. The famous Mark Cheen machine gun was invented by American Mark Cheen in 1883, but because smokeless gunpowder was not popular in the early days, there was no get reused. P. Vieri, a French chemist, successfully developed smokeless powder in 1884. The French developed the Lebel 1886 rifle on the basis of smokeless powder. The caliber was reduced to 8 mm. Smokeless powder can increase the range of the projectile. With the improvement of ballistic straightness and shooting accuracy, the world has since entered a period of modern warfare, and the queuing-to-kill tactics have gradually become a thing of the past. The combination of these two people should be able to help the Spanish army basically rise to a notch. In terms of military literacy, Alfonso III has also started to prepare for cooperation with the Germans and invited German officers to train. January 15 in the Grand Palace of Madrid, with the solemn military music, the Archbishop from the Vatican brought the crown to the head of Alfonso XII, and then the newly crowned king finished his declaration of succession in the palace, an ancient country officially has ushered in its new ruler. The next day when the king held a coronation ceremony in a simple manner just to pass on to the soldiers, the king and the army were united in the faith, the morale of the frontline troops was greatly encouraged, the defense line that the Carlos faction was struggling to support was finally broken, and the cities of the southern rebels were finally unwilling. In love with war, wherever the government goes, it surrenders to the wind on January 26th. When news of the last Carlist rebels raised their hands and surrendered to Madrid, the three-year rebellion finally came to an end. The light of peace shines on this ancient land again, but it can only be seen full of devastation, and the work of post-war reconstruction is urgent. At this moment, Alfonso XII finally began to change the country. It has been half a month since the end of the war, and there is no hustle and bustle during the war in Spain. The damage suffered by the war in the northern region is now being slowly repaired with the efforts of the government and local people. And other regions of the country are slowly showing a stable appearance. Inform Arsenio, Jurgos, and Castro that the three generals are coming to the palace. I have something to talk to them about. Alfonso instructed his servants to inform the three of them, his eyes turning to the map of Europe hanging in the hall. At this time, European rivals were competing, the British Empire was in full swing, and gunboat diplomacy made most countries in the world terrified. Although France next door was caught by surprise in the Franco-Prussian War a few years ago, its powerful army has become the second largest navy in the world and a strong competitor for British world hegemony. Italy, the neighbor of the Mediterranean Sea, is also one of the great powers in Europe, and its strength on paper is even greater than that of Spain. In 1875, the navy of various countries ranked 10th in the world with a total tonnage of 53,500 tons, the Italian navy ranked 6th in the world with a total tonnage of 80,000 tons, and the British Royal Navy with a tonnage of 467,700 tons, surpassing the second. France and the United States combined, ranked first in the world. In a short period of time, Spain is unable to catch up with the above-mentioned powers. The first and most important point is that Spain has no money. Today's Spain is no longer the empire on which the sun never sets. Bounce, there was a knock at the door, and Alfonso came back to his senses. Come in. The door of the conference room was pushed open, and the three generals walked in one after another. Guin, Your Majesty. The three greeted with a military salute. They didn't know what the king wanted them to come for. Generals, after the last civil war, I believe you have recognized the inadequacy of the army, and this time I invite you to come and discuss these issues. Alfonso paused and looked at the three people who looked at each other in dismay. The three of them showed embarrassment on their faces, but they didn't know how to refute them. How to solve these problems substantively is an urgent matter, so I think we should reform the military system, improve the quality of the soldiers, and strengthen the military equipment. I wonder what opinions the three have. After Alfonso finished speaking, he looked at the three. Castro was the first to stand up. As a staunch centralist general, Castro negotiated with the Bourbon family in 1874 to allow Alfonso to successfully restore. Your Majesty, first of all, the number of the army is too bloated. During the Carlos Rebellion, the number of the army once exceeded 300,000, and the surrendered soldiers of the Carlos faction also numbered 60,000, and the total number has reached an astonishing 360,000. Less than a third of military training, so I think the military should be thin first. After Castro finished speaking, he looked at Arsenio and Jurgos. Corruption in the military is very serious now, and it is not uncommon for them to take empty pay and embezzle military funds. And if there is a real layoff of the army, it will definitely move a lot of people's cakes, and this requires the support of the two powerful factions in the military. Your Majesty, the current situation in the army is rather bad. Corruption in the army must be strictly controlled. This is a subordinate's dereliction of duty, Arsenio unexpectedly said directly and bluntly about the current problems in the army. Alfonso shook his head and said, "The domestic situation was bad before, so I can't blame you, but the top priority is to solve this problem." After speaking, Alfonso pondered for a moment, tapped his finger on the table, and suddenly his eyes lit up and said, "The selection of supervisors from the army will begin tomorrow. The biggest role of the inspectors is to protect the rights and interests of grassroots soldiers. If there is any corruption in the military or anyone who violates the interests of the military, as well as those who violate the interests of the military, they can file a complaint with the Ministry of Supervision." The three generals were all bright, Alfonso continued. "Another role of the inspectors is to supervise the discipline of the army. The inspectors are recruited and sent to the grassroots level to maintain military discipline and combat effectiveness at all times. The inspectors also need to recruit a group of grassroots officers who can read, and every week they need to teach the soldiers to read and popularize the idea of loyalty and patriotism." Alfonso combined the pickets of later generations with the intelligence of political commissars, and introduced the concept of monitoring soldiers, which retained the acceptable functions of many times, and removed the traffic management in the military. After all, there are no cars in the military now. And what kind of traffic do you manage? I'll leave this to you, Arsenio. Alfonso assigned Arsenio to do this, and now only Arsenio has the ability to withstand the different voices in the army. "It's your majesty, I will definitely do it myself to accomplish this," Arsenio replied with a military salute. "Castro, you are in charge of the layoff of the army, and regarding the issue of the new army establishment, when I was studying in the UK, I studied the current army establishment in Germany. We can't copy the German system. Although they are the world's number one army, we have to find a development line that suits us." Castro responded, and then asked, "Your Majesty, how do you think we should reform the army? First of all, my country's standing army should be kept between 150,000 and 200,000 people. The army should have 8 infantry divisions, 2 cavalry divisions, and a total of 10 divisions in total. An infantry division has 3 infantry regiments, an artillery regiment, a regiment consists of 3 battalions, a battalion of 3 companies, and a company of 3 squads. An infantry company has about 245 people, an infantry battalion has about 1,000 people, and an infantry regiment has about 3,287 people. Together with logisticians and officers, a full division should have 16,000 people. A cavalry division consists of 46 cavalry regiments, a cavalry battalion, and a machine gun company. 1 cavalry regiment consists of 46 cavalry companies. The number of a cavalry company is about 150, and the number of a cavalry division is about 6,000. This adaptation needs to reduce the army of 360,000 people at the end of the war to 140,000 people, and the soldiers who remain must be strong and elite. UU reading www.uuganshu.com. Alfonso finished planning the army and turned to look like Jurgos. Jurgos was born in the Navy and was once a top student at the British Naval School. After graduating, he served in the Spanish Navy for 11 years. Later, because of the local rebellion, he was transferred to the army as a centralist. "Jurgos, the Navy needs your control. Currently, the kingdom only has warships of less than 60,000 tons. Although Jurgos also knows the current difficulties of the navy, as a Spaniard who loves the sea, the strength of the kingdom's navy has always been his ideal and goal. I need you to pay close attention to the training of the navy. After the initial recovery of our economy, the navy will plan to add several Staatoftart warships, and the current navy officers and soldiers, you must ensure that they can be used as officers." Alfonso stared at Jurgos, said in a low voice. "The navy is a behemoth that swallows gold. When it does not get foreign loans and the economy recovers, it cannot cultivate it." "Yes, your majesty." Jergo's face was firm, and the strength of the navy was his only belief. Above, after you go back, immediately designate a specific implementation plan and implement it as soon as possible. With solemn faces, the three of them saluted and exited the conference room. After the three of them exited, Alfonso held his forehead and looked at the various data presented on the table and couldn't help but ponder. Spain's current internal problems are still very serious. The confrontation between the workers and the bourgeoisie, and the increasingly serious land annexation in rural areas, no matter who moves, it will trigger a series of social unrest. Only with a strong army in hand can these stubborn diseases become pains. And the surrounding powerful countries make the construction of this army even more urgent and precious. Dear Your Majesty, thank you for your appreciation. We will definitely complete the task you entrusted to us. Mark Cheen was excited. Since the end of the Civil War, he has been employed by the Olympian Company in Boston, USA. The royalties brought by the fast fire extinguisher have also allowed him to live a rather prosperous life. But when a monarch of the great powers personally sent someone to look for him and confessed his admiration for him, the temptation of this kind of social status was indeed too great. He has been interested in weapons since he was a child. In history, he went to Europe to investigate in 1881, so under various reasons, the famous Maxim machine gun came out. As for the other two indispensable combinations of machine guns, one is the metal eggshell, and the other is the smokeless gunpowder that makes the World War extremely cruel. Since the advent of smokeless gunpowder, from the French's first smokeless gunpowder rifle, Lebel 1886, to the later Mosin Nagant rifle, Sheffield rifle and G98 rifle, the main weapon of the First World War has since then been start interviewing one by one. The birth of smokeless gunpowder also ushered in a huge development of artillery. The most advanced Armstrong breech gun in the UK can only shoot 2 shells per minute, and most of the time is used to restore the gun position. The French M1897 75mm rapid-fire gun, hydraulic short recoil mechanism and Kopp Erskine smokeless gunpowder shells, allow the cannon to fire 15 shells per minute. As Spain in this period, whether it is rifles, machine guns, artillery, this kind of light military industry can actually be built independently. What Spain lacked was someone to call their way, and Alfonso's presence just made up for this big shortcoming. Unlike the excited Maxim, Vieri, this scientist is more rational. Born into the middle class, he is less excited and more rational. Vieri glanced at the excited Maxim, and then asked Alfonso, "Why does Your Majesty like the two of us so much?" "Because of you, in Spain, we have just suffered a brutal civil war, we are eager to equip our army with better weapons, and you are the most suitable people I have observed after a long time." Alfonso didn't have much, with an encouraging smile. "I am very optimistic about the future of smokeless powder. I think it can replace the use of black powder in warfare, and you happen to be an expert in this area. And this Maxim next to you, I think he can make a firearm for firing smokeless powder. You are the best partners." Alfonso looked a little fanatical. As a military enthusiast in his previous life, he thought that it was indeed a wonderful thing for a world-famous weapon to come into being from him. "You persuaded me that I will work for you." Vialli's face was inevitably a little excited. As a truly talented person, a bull in the 19th century was indeed very important. "I'll work for you too." Maxim was overwhelmed with joy. As a child of a poor family in America, he expected status and wealth more than anyone else. "I don't know when His Majesty needs us to start working. I think my partner and I can't wait now." Vieri pointed to Maxim, who was already smiling. Alfonso also laughed when he saw this. "I have already arranged accommodation for you in the arsenal on the outskirts of Madrid. I have ordered someone to help you organize your research room. If you have arranged your life, I think you can work at any time." Alfonso also attaches great importance to the arrival of these two figures. This is an important figure in the Spanish army who has directly crossed 20 years. "Thank you, Your Majesty. I don't know what His Majesty's requirements for our work are. We will fulfill His Majesty's wish. Vieri said in the era of 1875, the Navy did not mention it for the time being. The main combat weapons of the Army were nothing but guns and cannons. I also got a cheap and easy Taos rifle, with a far longer range than the guns currently serving in the military, and a high accuracy. A gun that can fire countless bullets in an instant, I hope it can have a good suppressing effect on the enemy on the battlefield. A rapid-fire gun that can fire at a rate of 15 shells per minute and weighs no more than 1.5 tons. Alfonso told them according to the requirements of smokeless powder rifle, Maxim machine gun, and MS-75 rapid-fire gun. Of course, he also understands that such a requirement must be very strict in this era, but if he does not strictly rely on the natural development, then Alfonso does not need to invite them to work. You don't have to be afraid, your research, no matter what you need, financial, human, and material resources, will meet your needs. As a reward, I will set up a machinery company at the original site of the Madrid Arms factory, and each of you will have a percent of 5 shares. It's your majesty. Vieri and Maxim wanted to refuse, but they gave too much. For those who have no idea, you can think that you have a 5% stake in the Bay Arms factory. All weapons require smokeless powder to fire, so I hope to see smokeless powder come out first. I have 3 design drawings here, as well as some basic research results on smokeless gunpowder. The research results also know that it is nitrocellulose, nitroglycerin, and other things are written on it. And the design drawing directly plagiarized the appearance of Mosin Nagin, Maxim's machine gun, and MS-75 rapid-fire gun, and put some vaguely remembered points on it. The specific research and the real thing, we have to let these 2 people go. Implement. I will not disappoint your majesty's expectations. Mark Cheen took the blueprint, glanced at it, and replied. Alfonso smiled and waved his hand, there are already people out there who will send you back. Come on, get ready and start early. The 2 retreated. Howard, help me set up a military industry. The name is Spain's state-owned military manufacturing company. In the future, you will help me manage the business of this company. Now, help these 2 people to build what I want. It's your majesty. Howard also left. As an old man who has followed Alfonso for more than 10 years, Alfonso naturally knows his abilities. It's just an arms factory, and Howard has no problem. Inform Castro, let him start recruiting workers in the military factory among the demobilized soldiers, and the salary will be paid at 1.5 times the average wage. Alfonso asked the messenger to pass the word. Young and strong young people are naturally military factories. Workers' first choice. Alfonso suddenly had some anticipation. Everyone in the Spanish army was wearing a German 36TYPE military uniform and an M16TYPE helmet. Although mustache is not good, the army he commands is really handsome. Oh, yes. I actually forgot to draw the military uniform and let someone make it. Alfonso patted his head and forgot about this. The military reform has come to an end, and the liberals are afraid Rashid's has come with the report. Although the prime minister is held by the conservative Canovas, the post of chancellor of the exchequer is held by Rashid's. Good day, your majesty, the financial report for 1874 has come out. Do you need me to report it to you? Unlike Canovas, who seems to be very shrewd, Rashid's looks more shrewd and slightly narrowed. The eyes look more cautious. Alfonso nodded and motioned for him to continue. Our country's gross national product last year was 31 billion pesetas, fiscal revenue accounted for 8% of the gross national product, and the total revenue was 2.48 billion pesetas. Of which 912 million pesetas were spent on maintaining government guarantee operations and government officials' salaries. Towers, army maintenance and military salaries cost a total of 600 million pesetas. Among them, the military has been reduced by more than half, so next year's military expenditure may only be half of this year's. Because of last year's war, such as public facilities, education, etc., there was no investment, so this year's fiscal surplus was unexpectedly. Next year our available budget will be as much as 968 million. Afraid that Rashid's looked at King Alfonso XIII after reporting the situation, to be honest, next year's financial situation was somewhat unexpected. Alfonso was also a little surprised. There was more money available than expected, which was indeed a good thing. I'm afraid of Rashid's, I hope our investment should be on heavy industry, education, scientific research, and infrastructure construction. What do you think? Alfonso asked, although it was a question, but it was obvious that there was no doubt in his mouth. Naturally, Parquetes would not be disrespectful at this time, and replied, "Everything is subject to His Majesty's arrangement. Our navy's ability to build itself is too poor now, so I hope to build 4 shipyards in Barcelona, Valencia, Seville, and Bilbao that can provide warships for the navy. Construction of 4 steel plants in the 4 cities of Zaragoza, Palencia, Granada, and Cordoba, build 3 arsenals in 3 cities, Madrid, Burgos, and Toledo." Since he has money, Alfonso will naturally not spend all of it politely. The money spent is money. The budget is initially set at 400 million pesos, and the budget will be increased later according to the situation. 100 million pesos were allocated to the construction of primary and secondary schools and 4 universities, the University of Madrid, the University of Barcelona, the University of Granada, and the University of Zaragoza, and the schools were allocated to recruit experts in physics, chemistry, mathematics, and geography in European countries. As a person from later generations, Alfonso naturally knows the importance of education, and basic education should catch up. The United States, Germany, and other countries are in the period of the Second Industrial Revolution, and Alfonso naturally wants to seize this opportunity to overtake in corners. The government allocated 10 million yuan to set up the Spanish National Power Company, and went to the United States to hire electric power experts such as Tesla and Edison. After the company's framework for generators and other companies was completed, it made a lot of money to go to Germany's Siemens to cooperate, so that Spain must be in the new industry. Not lag behind other countries in the revolution. Allocation of 5 million pesos to go to Germany to hire Carl Benz, Diesel, and Daimler to set up a research laboratory for internal combustion engines. This must be an important invention. Communication with the German government shows that Spain intends to buy Krupp armored technology from them, and we are bound to acquire this technology. Allotted 10 million pesetas to set up a Spanish national communications company, and went to Boston to hire Scott Bell and German scientist Hertz. The government needs 5 million pesetas to set up the Royal Spanish newspaper. The government needs him to spread the message to the people. Alfonso said several times at once, making the clerk who was recording beside him scrambling. You can't blame Alfonso for being so urgent. The Second Industrial Revolution has quietly started in the United States and Germany, and various inventions and creations will blow out in the next 10 years. Internal combustion engines, generators, automobiles, communications, electrical appliances, these inventions that have penetrated into life in later generations are almost all created in this era. And by spending so much money at one time, when various enterprises are born in Spain, they will also create hundreds of thousands or even millions of jobs for Spain. When people have a job, they will have money in their hands. If they have money in their hands, they will naturally think about spending. Those who get opportunities at work are not lacking in people who go out and start their own businesses, which will also drive countless small and medium-sized enterprises to blow out. Appeared on this land. Spain had to move away from an agricultural economy to an industrial economy in order to gain a place in the rivalry of the great powers. The disadvantage of vigorously developing industry is naturally that farmers leave the farmland and enter the factory. If the big nobles who own a lot of land do not want to be squeezed out of the market by foreign grains step by step, they will naturally seek more efficient planting methods. Instead of tying farmers to the land by means of employment, the low labor cost only causes the great aristocrats to stop innovating, thus stagnating agricultural technology. Afraid of Rashids, in his own name, he contacted grain companies in the United States and Russia to prevent local grain shortages, and he could import their grain with a bottom line without lack of grain in the early stage. This is also to prevent future troubles. Spending a little money can ensure the supply of food. UU Reading www.uuganshu.com. The people I named and hired above, quickly arranged people to contact them, and if they were willing to come to Spain, bring them to see me in Madrid. Each of them is a talent that I value, and they are the same as the previous Maxim and Viali. Alfonso explained to Ray Sides. On the one hand, he wanted to use his status as a monarch to attract their attention and improve the success rate of bringing them back to Spain. On the other hand, he wanted to communicate with the scientists who had agreed to return to China. Experience from later generations. Many of them are geniuses, such as Edison, Tesla, etc. Sometimes they just lack a flash of inspiration. As modern people who have traveled back 150 years later, they can naturally guide them to the right place. Someone asked why he didn't do it himself. Nonsense, if Alfonso remembers everything, it's science fiction rather than historical fiction. In addition, let Arsenio and Jurgos prepare to serve as ministers of the army and navy, and let them come to the palace to discuss with me the issue of military spending between the two armies in 1875. Alfonso XIII told the liberal leader that after the war, these two positions were always vacant, and government ministers were almost unmanned. Then go to Canovas. The two of you go back to discuss the candidate for the vacant minister's position. Come to the palace the day after tomorrow and let me take a look. Afraid that Rashids hurriedly agreed, he was already shocked by Alfonso in this short period of time. Although he didn't know the talents mentioned by His Majesty, when Alfonso named these people by name, he knew that the king must have studied them carefully before. Otherwise, how could you call out so many people from all over the world? The next day, Arsenio and Jurgos, who had been appointed by Alfonso as ministers of the army and navy, came to the meeting room of the Royal Palace of Madrid early to wait. As the direct heads of the army and navy, they naturally learned the purpose of coming today from the Chancellor of the Exchequer Fir Rashids. Even if it is a comrade in arms who can be entrusted to the back during the war, when faced with the issue of military expenditure distribution, the two of them are staring at each other with bad expressions. At this time, Alfonso had just been served by the maid to wash up and came here. As soon as he opened the door, he saw two people who were arguing with swords. "Good morning, gentlemen." Alfonso greeted them with a smile, and he was more than happy to see this situation. "Good morning, Your Majesty." The two of them gave a military salute and said in agreement, "I called the two of you today, mainly because I want to make some allocations on the planning of military spending in 1875. Alfonso tucked the corner of his clothes and sat on the main seat. "Please take a seat. This year's Navy and Army budget is much higher than in the past few years, mainly because last year there was basically no investment in all walks of life because of the war, so the total budget of the Navy and Army this year is as high as 300 million pesetas." Alfonso said. "Among them, the army plans to complete the replacement by the end of 1875, including rifles, cannons, and new weapons and machine guns, with a total budget of 80 million match towers." Alfonso finished talking about the army's budget in one breath, then turned to look at Jurgos. "Jurgos, I have a drawing of a battleship here, which I designed with great concentration during my time in England. This battleship is 125 meters long and 22.9 meters wide, the average draft is 8.4 meters, and the displacement at full load is 22.9 meters. In terms of firepower, four 343mm guns and 10 152.4mm rapid-fire guns are used. In terms of protection, the thickness of the main armor is not less than 457mm. and considering that the low freeboard of the traditional ironclad fleet often makes the artillery unusable, this time we will use a high freeboard design. After Alfonso finished speaking, he looked like Jurgos and wanted to see his reaction. Your Majesty, if this battleship is really what you said, then it will be the most powerful battleship in the world. Jurgos looked excited. If this battleship really joined the Spanish Navy, that would be a huge boost for the Spanish Navy. Quickly bring the drawings to the Nava NTIA shipyard, let the designers inside improve it, and then plan the construction. Jurgos told the entourage outside the door that the Nava NTIA shipyard was a native of Spain in the 18th century. The continuation of the three major shipyards is also the only shipyard in Spain that can handle it later. The cost of this warship is estimated at 2.1 million pesetas, plus the cost of shells, personnel, and the above. The budget is 2.5 million pesetas. If it is feasible, then I will approve 12.5 million pesetas and use to build 5 ships, and allocate 10 million pesetas to build various auxiliary fleets. Alfonso said in a deep voice. Next year, all shipyards will be on full fire, and the new tonnage should be 120,000 tons in the next 3 years. Shipbuilding must try their best to conceal it. Although there is no way to hide the fact that shipyards across the country start construction together, it can be delayed for one day. In addition, we will step up the recruitment of the Navy to ensure that the battleship can quickly become combat power when it is launched. After Alfonso finished speaking, he looked like Arsenio. The Army's training was originally planned to invite Germans to train. But with the birth of smokeless gunpowder weapons, it is obviously not suitable for queuing to be shot. The Army will soon bring in a new batch of weapons, and the tactics of queuing to kill are no longer suitable for us. This book records some of my experience in training the new Army. This time our Army will also be at the forefront of the world. This book is Alfonso's soldier training based on World War I and World War II and some classic tactics, such as trenches, barbed wire, artillery washing and so on. The steps can't be too big, it's easy to get involved, and the weapons and equipment are obviously more suitable for World War I and World War II. Strengthening the combat effectiveness of the army is an urgent matter, and the previous Spanish army did not benefit much from the Battle of the Colonial Army. Perhaps among the major European powers, only the legendary Italian army has a lower combat effectiveness than him. That is a top-level army that even the African natives with big swords and spears can't beat. And more importantly, the colony needed a strong and shrewd army to deal a fatal blow to the colony's rebels. Although Spain's mainland has been pacified, the two largest overseas colonies, Cuba and the Philippines, are still in chaos. Cuba's War of Independence is in a stalemate. Historically, in early 1877, A.M. de Campos led 25,000 reinforcements to Cuba, and barely ended the war in 1878. And in the Americas in the northern part of Cuba, they are already salivating, ready to pounce on the once big empire and bite a piece of meat. The current Cuban Independence Army would not have been able to last for so long without the support of the Americans behind it. The Philippines in Asia is also full of riots. After the end of the Spanish-American War in history, the United States won the Philippines, and the Philippine insurgents immediately fought against the U.S. military. The Philippines is different from Cuba. Cuba, like most of the former Spanish colonies, has a majority of Hispanic descendants, so the country speaks Spanish. In addition to Brazil, Spanish is also recognized as the first language in South America. The Philippines is different. It has a long journey and a large indigenous population. They say that the indigenous people who need it are the majority, and independence has always been their goal. And too many indigenous people have also caused poor management. Although the Philippines is rich in natural resources and brings extremely high benefits, the high management expenditure also makes this money not very impressive. The army and navy must become stronger as soon as possible. The resistance of the colonies has intensified. We need the army to silence these voices, and this time is destined to not be too long. After Alfonso finished speaking, he took a deep look at the two of them. The inside was weak, and there were wolves staring at you from the outside, ready to take a bite of meat on you. Now the army and navy really need to grow up quickly to solve this dilemma. And Arsenio and Jurgos are also solemn, they are naturally aware of the foreign and internal troubles of the motherland. Yes, Your Majesty, we will complete the training of the troops in the shortest time, and then wait for the arrival of new equipment to quickly form combat effectiveness. Then go get ready, your task is very arduous, and you can't make mistakes for a minute. After the two retreated, Alfonso stared at the map expressionlessly. The huge Spanish ship had ushered in the most suitable helm for her. The general blueprint has been drawn, and the follow-up only needs to be tinkered with this framework. Alfonso believes that in the near future, in this epic era of great powers competing for hegemony, his Spain and him will definitely be the brightest page. In April 1875, the weather in Madrid gradually warmed up. Compared with the cold winter, Alfonso was more suitable for the warm spring. Your Majesty, Maxim, and Vieri are asking to see you. They are already waiting in the conference room. Howard opened the door and said to Alfonso, who stood up and moved his muscles because of sitting for a long time. Could it be that their research has yielded results? Alfonso's eyes lit up, and he asked with his hands on the table. Let's go, let's have a look. After speaking, he walked towards the conference room in the lead. Only Howard, who was slightly depressed, was left. At this time, in the conference room, Maxim Huvieri was talking when the door of the conference room suddenly opened. Hey, guys, has the weapon I wanted come to fruition? Alfonso was more excited, no wonder, this is an epic-making product. Yes, Your Majesty, the thing you asked for has some key points that you provided us. The finished product has already been made. The two looked at each other and replied. Where's the stuff? Alfonso was even more excited. We have already arranged the carriage and put it all in the carriage. Vierly answered first, he always seemed more reliable than Maxim. It has been a few months since the arrival of Mark and Chin. The smokeless powder, machine guns, rapid-fire artillery, and smokeless rifles they are in charge of, although they have been produced in a few months, feel a little unreliable. But when a modern person from the 21st century helps them bring up the important points, it is not surprising. Geniuses may be missing a certain key point, and Alfonso may not know most of them, but he just knows some important points. Such a complementarity is naturally fast. Let's go and have a look. I can't wait. Alfonso urged the two of them, which of you are going to drive their carriage over? We will go directly to the experimental site together. Along the way, he ordered the guards who were guarding him to take the two to the experimental site. The experimental field of the Royal Palace of Madrid is more like a garden than an experimental field. After all, how could there be such a thing as an experimental field in a royal palace? After a while, the guards drove the carriage to the side, and several guards hurriedly removed the weapons from the carriage. Your Majesty wants to see the test firing of that kind of weapon first. Maxim asked. Let's look at machine guns first. I'm most interested in machine guns. Alfonso said, he really had a soft spot for machine guns. I saw Mark Chin greeted the two guards, they gave a few words, and gestured at the machine gun. The two soldiers had already stepped in front of the machine gun and started to become proficient. 200 meters away, several soldiers had already moved a large rock. Your Majesty, it's ready to shoot. After the soldiers who placed the target stones withdrew, Mark Chin said. Let's start. I can't wait. Alfonso couldn't hide his excitement. As a law-abiding Chinese citizen in his previous life, Alfonso had never seen a real gun. The appearance of the machine gun is very similar to the Maxim machine gun, but there is a slight difference. Above the thick triangular bracket is a barrel with a thick fist, and the bullets are stored in a straight iron box, that is, the magazine. A machine gun magazine contains 100 rounds of ammunition, and there are dozens of magazines in the car. I think it should be well prepared. Two soldiers put the magazine on the machine gun slightly jerky, one soldier was dragging a ribbon-like metal bullet, and the other soldier was already at the firing position. Pumba! With Alfonso's order, the machine gun began to fire snakes in anger, the bullets fired in rapid succession formed a straight line, and the irritable voice continued. Oh, it's so exciting, it's incredible. Alfonso jumped up excitedly. This violent metal storm could not be rejected by the man, and the large stones in front of them that were used as targets gradually became fragmented from the concave small holes. Go and inform General Arsenio, let him come quickly, and tell him that the army's killer has come out. Alfonso said to another guard, then pointed to the artillery and rifle. Quick, try these two too. And the guard who tested the fire was obviously shocked, and after a while, he realized that he trotted over to get the rifle. Man, I'll teach you how to use it. Maxim walked over together and picked up the rifle. The first characteristic of this rifle is that it is long and compact. It uses the same 7.62mm bullet as Maxim, which is a unified caliber for the convenience of industrial production. Ping, ping, Maxim loaded 5 bullets and fired twice in a row. The sound of dripping water sounded. This is the anti-manufacturing version of the Mosin Nagant rifle. The effective range of this rifle is 600,800 meters, and it can be loaded with 5 bullets at a time, while all the Dreiser rifles used by the German army have an effective range of no more than 600 meters and can only be shot in a single shot. Our rifles are now the best in the world. Mark Cheen said with a little interest, after all, this rifle was made by him. There is also the last rapid-fire artillery, which has an effective range of 8,500 meters and a theoretical maximum rate of fire of 2 seconds per round, while the German Krupp artillery has a maximum rate of fire of 6 rounds per minute, and their effective range is only 3,500 meters, while France's maximum range is only 2,000 meters. Vieri said, after all, the limelight can't let Mark Cheen go out alone, and he looks like Alfonso. Before Alfonso could answer, Arsenio hurried over. Your Majesty, where are my guns and cannons? Arsenio was also a little excited. The army he was in charge of finally added a big killer. No, it's these three, and the artillery hasn't been tested yet. Just when you came, let's take a look. Alfonso pointed to the 75mm gun. This time, there were no soldiers to operate. In order to experience the fire rate of the artillery, Vieri and Maxim started it themselves, one loaded and the other fired. Put, pound, pound, pound. In just 1 minute, the 75mm artillery fired 16 shells. It's great, I don't know when these weapons can be equipped in the army, which can greatly improve our military strength. Alfonso didn't speak, and turned to look like Howard. In the large arsenal on the outskirts of Madrid, 3 large independent workshops have been opened for the production of these weapons. Among them, rifles, machine guns and cannons can be installed in the entire army in 2 months. But the 7.62mm bullet of the same caliber may not keep up with the supply because Maxim's bullet consumption is relatively large. There will also be a shortage of artillery shells, but the pre-training is guaranteed. Howard said meticulously, UU reading www.uuganju. As the old man behind Alfonso, he had already arranged all this. The entire army is reloaded with rifles, 2 machine guns per shift, and 1,000 cannons. The government placed an order with the Spanish state-owned military manufacturing co., limited to expand the bullet production line of the Madrid Arms factory. The Madrid second factory, which has already started construction, bore the Goss plant and the Toledo plant are all placed under the Spanish state-owned military manufacturing co., Limited. Alfonso said, start manufacturing with all your strength from today, Arsenio, I need you to start today, within 3 months, so that the army can form combat effectiveness. Arsenio nodded and saluted. Let Pairs Hides contact local textile companies, and make sure the army wears new uniforms within 2 months. The new military uniform that Alfonso mentioned is the German 36 military uniform, boots and M16 helmet he mentioned last time. Rifle named Vialli 1875 rifle, formerly Mosin Nagant rifle. The machine gun is named as the Maxim 1875 machine gun, the original Maxim machine gun. The artillery is named ESP-1875 artillery. ESP is the English abbreviation of Spain, the original French M1897 artillery, also known as MIS 75mm. Vialli and Maxim were very excited when they heard that the rifle and the machine gun were named after them respectively. With such a naming method, they would definitely be recorded in the Spanish history books. On the other hand, Arsenio, Howard, and others looked at them enviously. After all, the honor of naming the king himself is not something ordinary people can enjoy. What's more, these three epoch-making weapons can indeed make them leave their own page in Spain and even in the world. Therefore, the history of world wars will be rewritten and a new chapter will be opened. Zaragoza, Palencia, Granada, Cordoba. Since the day before yesterday, His Majesty the King personally confirmed that 4 steel mills will be built in these 4 famous Spanish cities. Technicians and workers have begun to gather one after another. At this time, the Royal Palace of Madrid. Your Majesty, the German ambassador has arrived. Howard walked in and said to Alfonso, who was writing something at the desk. Alfonso put down the pen in his hand for writing and drawing and asked, "Where?" Already waiting in the parlor, Alfonso stood up and moved his muscles. "Then let's go." As soon as Alfonso entered the door of the parlor, he saw Matt, the German ambassador, seated seriously. "Hello, Mr. Matt, you are welcome to visit the palace during your busy schedule." Alfonso was obviously different from the German royal family, who followed the nobility etiquette and greeted Matt first. "It's a pleasure to meet you, Your Majesty." Matt obviously inherited the rigidity and rigor of the German aristocracy, and treats etiquette meticulously. "Mr. Matt, you must have heard some wind," Alfonso said straight to the point. "After all, this transaction will obviously not be too short." "I've heard a little bit. I heard that your country is going to build 4 steel factories, which are already arsenals. I think Your Majesty is here for this, right?" Matt's answer also named the subject, and Alfonso really came for this matter. "Then I won't tell you the secret. We want to learn from your country's steel manufacturing experience, and we can sell a batch of excellent artillery to your country." "Artillery? As far as I know, there doesn't seem to be any good artillery in your country." "Matt is right, Spain did not have a relatively good artillery to prove itself before." Hearing Alfonso smile involuntarily, the last time Spain became famous internationally was probably the Spanish throne that prompted the outbreak of the Franco-Prussian War. It seems that the ambassador's news is not very well informed, which is a thing of the past. After speaking, Alfonso took out a piece of data from his desk and handed it to Matt, the German ambassador. 75mm caliber, 1,160 kg gun weight, 2.7m gun length, 8500m effective range, 529m/s. Alfonso looked at Matt, who was a little panicked in front of him, with some amusement. Before that, who didn't know that the Germans had the best artillery in Europe, even the eldest French can't match it. And when this data, which is at least 20 years older than Germany, is placed in front of him, the mood as a German can be imagined. "I don't know what this is." Matt's expression was a little unnatural, and he was even unwilling to believe it. "This is the latest ESP-1875 rapid-firing artillery developed in my country, and the data is all on it." Alfonso squinted his eyes with a smile, and took a sip of the freshly brewed tea. "It's impossible. If the data on this drawing really appears in reality, then all the artillery in use now will look like a toy. Mark has already lost his temper. After all, the data recorded in this document is really like a talk in the sky." Alfonso stood up unhurriedly and lightly tidied up his clothes. "Let's go, Mr. Ambassador, You don't seem to believe the truth of this data, so I'll take you to see the real thing." After speaking, Alfonso stretched out his hand and made a gesture of invitation. "It is better to be respectful than to obey, please, Your Majesty the King." Matt also got up and said, he couldn't believe it if he didn't see the real thing. The two took the carriage of the Imperial Palace to the experimental site. "Guards, pull out the cannon and fire quickly for 2 minutes." Alfonso waved at the guards at the testing ground and shouted. Yes, the guards dragged a brand new 75mm cannon from the warehouse. Then four guards stepped onto the launch post, ready to launch. "Aim at 8,000 meters ahead and fire at the limit in 2 minutes." After Alfonso gave the order, he looked at Matt next to him. "Look well, Matt." Matt nodded and didn't speak. "Prepare, let go." The guard signaled that the preparation was over, and Alfonso nodded to start. Ping, 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 ping. The continuous sound of artillery began to sound, and under the skilled palace guards, an ESP-1875 artillery began to roar. After 2 full minutes of firing, the number of shell casings on the ground had reached an astonishing 40. "Well, Mr. Ambassador, this artillery should be eligible to participate in the transaction." Alfonso turned his head and said to Matt, who was stunned. At this time, Matt didn't make a big uproar. He didn't expect that Spain, which in his eyes had always been the role of a declining empire, would actually come up with such an amazing mark. "I think there's no problem, Your Majesty, but I don't have the authority to make such a big decision for the German Empire." Matt pondered for a while after speaking. "If possible, I hope His Majesty can hand me a copy of this artillery data. I will send it back to China. Please discuss it in the country." Matt said, at this moment, he was already reluctant to part with this shocking cannon. "Of course there is no problem, Mr. Ambassador, but please give me an answer as soon as possible. I will wait for you at the Royal Palace of Madrid." Alfonso nodded to indicate that there was no problem, this should be a normal process. After saying goodbye, Matt hastily returned to his place of work, ready to report the matter to the country. "Your Majesty the Emperor, in the westernmost kingdom of Spain in Europe, UU reading www.yukanshu.com, I have been summoned by King Alfonso XII of Spain. His Majesty Alfonso hopes to reach cooperation with my country, and the Spanish side hopes to obtain our steel-making technology and send relevant experts to give technical guidance. Correspondingly, they are willing to sell the latest artillery developed in Spain. This is an artillery of the era of modernization. I have witnessed it in Spain to rapidly fire 40 shells in 2 minutes. And his effective range has reached 8 kilometers, which is almost twice the range of our artillery. Therefore, after the King of Spain made this proposal, I immediately called back to China, hoping that the role and value of this artillery can be carefully evaluated in China. The specific artillery data are as follows: effective range 8500 m, rate of fire 30 rounds/s, weight 1160 kilograms. After returning, Matt started sending telegrams like a domestic telegram without a moment's mistake. At this time, in Germany, the Chancellor's office. Bismarck, who is already 70 years old, is still meticulous in handling his official duties. This iron-blooded Prime Minister who single-handedly united Germany is also showing a bit of old style. "Your Excellency Prime Minister, Matt, the ambassador to Spain, sent a telegram," the assistant said to Bismarck with a telegram. "Oh? Leave it here." Apparently, he was also a little surprised. There were not many telegrams from Spain. Bismarck took it casually, squinting at Matt's telegram, his originally casual expression gradually turned serious. "Prepare the carriage and go to Sanssouci Palace to meet His Majesty the Emperor." After speaking, he picked up the jacket on the chair, his face solemn. There is bound to be a violent turmoil within the young country of the German Empire.